Hi friends, which is a better investment, stock market or mutual fund? All of us have got this confusion in our mind because we are new to this area. Of course, stock market is in India for the past 150 years. Mutual fund industry is with us for more than 55 years. But still, we have not bothered much to go near them. If somebody talks about investment, it is only real estate, gold and FD. We never look beyond. Moreover, the word stock market had a very negative connotation to it previously. There was no transparency and there were a lot of scams like Harshad Mehta scam, Ketan Parekh scam. Because of all that, it was treated as some sort of gambling or horse racing. And we were also very, very hesitant to go near them. But today, the return from all the other asset classes have reduced. And money making machines are only stock market and mutual fund. So sort of we are compelled to go near them. And when we go there and we look there, there are two paths available to us. One is the direct investing, the other is the mutual fund route. So which to take? That confusion automatically comes to us. But if we are able to see some three parameters, we may be able to get some clarity. The first parameter is risk and return. Which asset class has the most return and most risk? Naturally, it is stock market. If we are able to identify a very good stock and buy it at a very cheap price, there is nothing like it. It will multiply like a rabbit 4 or 5 times in a year and will give us a lot of profit. But by mistake, if we choose a wrong stock, it will tumble down like anything and it will pull our portfolio also with it. In mutual fund industry, risk is also less, return is also less. Risk is less because of two reasons. One is the mutual fund manager. He is at the helm of the affairs. He is trained for it. He is a very knowledgeable person. He has been trained to manage risk. That is his job. The second reason is the mutual fund industry itself has been designed in such a way that risk is mitigated. Every scheme will have in its portfolio at least 30 to 40 stocks. Because of that, even if one or two stocks tumble down, another 3 or 4 will go up and keep up the stability of the scheme. For example, at one point of time, Yes Bank shares fell from 240 to just 45, 80% reduction. And many of our individual friends, investors have been affected by that. But even though all the mutual fund schemes are invested in Yes Bank shares, none of them got so badly affected. There is one more reason also to it. They have got a rule that in any scheme, not more than 10% can be invested in a single stock. That is why any single stock's volatility, ups and downs, never affects a mutual fund scheme. Next comes time availability and control. There are 5,000 stocks in Indian stock market and in that more than 2,400 stocks are being actively traded. And we need at least 5 stocks for our portfolio. To identify those 5 stocks, we should have thoroughly researched at least 50 stocks. We should know their business model, their profit, their loss, whether the sector is good, whether the sector is in the upswing. What about the national and the international environment, whether it is conducive for growth? All these things and more we have to know. Not only when buying, even when holding and even while exiting, we should know these things. Our knowledge should be thoroughly updated. Data is available in plenty, but who has got the time to read it, understand it and implement it? If you have got the time and the ability, like Dali Khanna or like Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, we can also make money. Already, most of us are struggling with work-life balance. So if you have got the time and the ability, you can right away go for stock market. And control also, you have full control there. Whatever you want, you can buy. Whatever, whenever you want, you can sell. You have got total control over your portfolio. In mutual fund, we don't require so much time because the fund manager is totally in charge. He will take care of the stock selection. Holding time, it is exiting time, all those things he will take care. We need not spend much time on that research. Maximum, we may have to look at the portfolio of the scheme, the performance of the manager, and the social environment. For that, we don't require much time. But for this luxury, we have to pay a price. That is a part of our profit. We might have heard of multi-baggers in a stock market, but we will never hear about a multi-bagger in a mutual fund in a single year, because our profit is being shared. The profit will be surely more than what an FD can give, but we don't get the multi-bagger effect here. Control. The fund manager has got the total control over the scheme, and we have nothing to say there. Even if we realize that he is making some small errors by churning his portfolio very frequently, be buying and selling and affecting the profitability, we have got nothing to say. The control is with him. The next parameter is charges and commission. Whenever we trade in the stock market, we buy or sell, we have to pay brokerage and commission. Apart from that, some companies are providing us the platform to hold our stocks, like ICICI Securities or SBI Cap. For those companies, we have to pay the service charges and demat charges. Apart from these, whatever we earn in the market will come to us in full. But in mutual fund, there is entry load, exit load, AMC charges, expense ratio, all that and more, because the mutual fund company has to run. It has to pay for the fund manager. It has to take care of the advertisement charges. It has to pay the brokerage. There are so many expenses it has to take care of. From where will they get the money? Only from the profit that they have made in the investments. Because of that, our profit will be reduced. So far we have seen the advantages and disadvantages of stock market and mutual funds in these three angles. Now, you tell me, which is a better investment? Nobody can tell anybody else, because it totally depends upon our own self. All of us need money. All of us need more money. And all of us need more money very fast. There's no doubt about it. But whether we have got the time and the ability to earn it in the stock market, if we have it, we can as well immediately plunge into it and make a lot of money. But people who don't have it, or people who come to this area for the first time, they can take the mutual fund route, and slowly they can learn the tricks. They can see the ups and downs of the market. They can grow their research abilities, and slowly they can turn their attention to direct investing. But there are some people, very aggressive investors, they don't have patience for all that mutual fund thing first and stock market next. No, they don't have the patience. They will think, what I am going to earn in 7 years in this mutual fund, I will earn within 1 year in the stock market. And they are right. Those people who want to enter into the stock market immediately, I have got a small suggestion. You can divide your funds into two. 50% you invest in mutual fund. The other 50% you put in direct investing and see whether you have got the time and the ability. Then later you can decide which way to go. All these things depend upon the type of investor that we are. Whatever type of investor you may be, I wish you all the very best.